Hello again. Just preparing something quick for next week to have for lunch. It's been a while. I don't do my special pasta salad. So I'm gonna show you. The only problem is I'm gonna explain the normal ingredients. So we have a pasta. It's nice if you have the color pasta, like the one is like green, normal, and orange. It looks very nice. And then it has corn, cherry tomatoes, halved, tuna, olives. Ideally should be like the Spanish olives, you know, they've got anchovy inside, but if not, just, you know, use like maybe black olives, sliced. So that's why, oh, and pineapple. So this is like the basic, and then I do some like pink mayo, which basically is like a bit of mayo, when it's time to serve, eh? So I just add some, it's like a mixture of mayo, ketchup, and a little bit of mustard. But now I'm gonna show you, because taking into account we're being locked at home for a week, we have what we have in the fridge, we need to use it. So I'll show you how I'm gonna maybe add some ingredients that I normally don't use. Right, so what we have here is a pasta, 200 grams of pasta. I mean, ideally colored pasta looks pretty, but it's fine, we have what we have. And then a cup of frozen corn, which can be boiled on the last 5 minutes with the pasta. It's all been drained, and then I added cold water to stop the cooking process and let it rain very well. We don't want watery pasta salad. So what I'm gonna add in this case, which is what we have from the fridge, is luckily we have tuna. My recommendation is add tuna with olive oil, or if not, with sunflower oil, and put the oil in the pasta, because it is nice, it is healthy, to be honest. Everyone says, oh, sunflower oil, blah blah blah, but you know, it's not going to be fried, it's going to be it's normal oil. So add everything here, it's going to be a very nice flavor. And then I'm gonna add some normal tomatoes, some onions, I'm gonna cut some celery, not a lot because I don't want to overwhelm, and then I'm gonna shred some carrots, and I'll show you how it looks afterwards. So far I add like the tuna, including the oil. I did the half moon tomatoes. I don't want to square them, otherwise it's gonna be too liquidy. One thing I wanted to mention is try to go for organic, especially with celery. It just tastes so different. It's I heard that a normal celery got so many chemicals, you know, and organic is just so different. I'm not sure about the price difference, but the taste is much nicer. Right, so here I have everything. I have my shredded carrots, these two carrots, the tomato, a little bit of spring onions that I had in the fridge, sitting by their own, and some celery. I'm gonna mix everything and then put it on the fridge, and this is gonna give us like two lunch times for two people. So I mix up everything, I make sure the olive oil or the sunflower oil is coating the whole salad. If your tuna doesn't have oil, just, you know, add like 1 or 2 tablespoons of like extra virgin olive oil, maybe some pepper. I wouldn't put salt, because then it's gonna make the vegetables go watery, and also I'm gonna serve this with the pink mayo. The other thing you can do is when it's serving time, feel free to add maybe some extra salad and some egg. I prefer to add the egg separately and not mix up, and also recommend to eat this room temperature, or not like very very cold.